In this video, I am going to explain very important anatomical place that you can approach from head, then you can approach to inside part of vertebra. That means you can approach to spinal cord. How is that possible? Because spinal cord is inside of vertebra. I don't mean you can directly go through spinal cord. I can't do that because I am not brain surgery doctor. However, if you see today's anatomical connection, you can go indirectly. Okay? Let me explain relationship of central nervous system and head. Okay, this is brain and cranium. Okay? Imagine there is brain. Now, there's brain, then spinal cord emerges from head, correct? Imagine this is brain, then brain becomes brainstem. Brainstem becomes then spinal cord. This area is kind of in between brainstem and spinal cord. Anyway, this is spinal cord. Spinal cord emerges from occiput, correct? Remember this relationship. This is occiput. There should be C1, cervical spine 1, also known as atlas. C1, then C2. Occiput, C1, C2. Do you see this relationship? Now let me go back to spine model. Okay, you saw relationship of brain, spinal cord, and occiput, correct? This is occiput. This is C1, atlas. This is C2, okay? Now, how can I go into spinal cord? Okay, I need to talk about few tissues. The first one is very tiny muscle that connects occiput and C1. That is rectus capitis posterior minor. This muscle is part of suboccipital muscles. Again, this is rectus capitis posterior minor. This is very, very deep muscle. Okay, this muscle. There is connective tissue that also connects occiput and atlas, C1. So the name of this tissue is atlanto-occipital membrane. Atlanto-occipital membrane. This membrane and muscle are very close, very, very close. Muscle, connective tissue, then you are going close to inside part of vertebra. Now there's one more tissue that surrounds spinal cord. What is it? That is dura mater. Dura mater covers spinal cord and brain. Okay, again, rectus capitis posterior minor. Atlanto-occipital membrane. Then, this membrane and dura mater are very, very close. So, via muscle, via connective tissue, and via membrane, I can access to spinal cord from outside. Do you see this relationship? Let's see, this is my finger. I put finger here. If I can access to rectus capitis posterior minor, I can go deep, 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 not directly, but indirectly, atlanto-occipital membrane, then dura mater. If you understand this relationship, maybe that can be help for neck pain. That can help range of motion. Maybe that can help headache. Why? Because dura mater covers spinal cord and brain. Imagine this membranous continuation is anywhere inside part of cranium and vertebra. Again, if I can access through this muscle, through this membrane, I can go to spinal cord. Maybe that can help tight neck, neck pain, or headache. This connection is very, very important. So in this video, I explained very important anatomical connection of outside of neck and inside part of neck. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.